ourselves in the foot so many times that we're the own cause of our casualties. How many of us pay bills?
I don't know.
The government will still leave you with a catastrophe has that hidden fees. Mm-hmm. And now you're on bended knees asking the Lord to release you from these demons, but wait. Why do we only love God when it's convenient?
Mm-hmm. What are you talking about?
Why do we only love God? When it's convenient, we wait till we down to our last to pick up a Bible and start reading, but still, we can't even rely on this because our Bible knowledge doesn't exist, so you don't pick up the Bible and go to Genesis. You put down that Bible, picking up a bottle, hoping that'll help. Now you're back at the beginning, hoping that Jim assists, so. I got another question. Why do we give God ultimatums? You ever give God an ultimatum, like, you do this for me, I'll do that for you? So why don't we give God an ultimatum, and then when it's time for prayer on Sunday morning, you're at the front of the church thinking, this is what I did last time, and he took care of me? Maybe the ultimatum. Look, I'm not going to lie to you. God isn't going to make a deal with you every time you get yourself in a pickle. He's going to let you relish in that situation until you figure out that it's time for you to move around, because he is a God with no limits, and he can prove it now. He just refuses to give you a spiritual blessing when your flesh is still acting juvenile. Yeah.
Yes,
because we forget how to raise our voice to be kings, because nowadays they either want to be drug lords or drag queens or disrespect our women with domestic relationships and drag queens. See, we're not treating them like queens. We're treating them like regular human beings, taking a crown that they worked so hard for. Just to think, I thought that was just a Steve Harvey thing. So maybe if we think like a man, our sons will think like a man too, and maybe even put a little heart in the things that they do. See, that's why I came with it at my own son. Just so I can teach him. Not how to be who I was, but to teach him who I will be, and maybe someday he will eclipse me. Now pay attention to that line, because that was one of the kind. I said, he will eclipse me. That means I'll be around to make sure my son is comfortable.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
He
raises his hand. Yes, I'll be around to make sure my son is covered, but as soon as I pass, I know my son is a shot.
Amen.
Another thing, we have to be comfortable in the skin that we're in.
Yes.
See, I know for a fact that I'm comfortable in my own, and I know it's easy for me to tell you to find a way to be successful. We've been struggling for too long, but find a way to be successful. We've been struggling for too long. You can't just stay and dash yourself away from your skin tone.
Yeah. Yes.
You can't just Stacey dash yourself away from
Shade
your skin
like
tone. You gotta let the feet drive you like Flintstone. See, understand. In order to get to paradise, you gotta roll a pair of dice in. The only reason I put this in the poem is because sometimes I forget to take my own advice. Thank y'all.